Hi, my name is Ida Birland and I'm an environmentalist. And I'm here to share some things that you can do for the environment. Because new studies have shown that we only have until 2050 before our planet can't be repaired anymore. It can't bounce back after that unless we make some drastic changes here. And though corporations are responsible for most of what gets put out there, I will be sharing some things that you as a person can do to help the environment. Only buy what you absolutely need. Leave those things that you're not really sure that you want or not really sure that you absolutely need. Leave those in the store. Because honestly, if you don't love it, when you see it, you're never gonna use it. Limit the things you buy that contain plastic or that comes in like plastic packaging. For example, if you snack a lot, trade, for example, like yogurt cups for fruits or something along those lines. Limit your purchasing of plastic. The things that you can buy used, do so. I'm not saying buy used socks or used underwear. Please don't. That is begging for a yeast infection. Don't do that. But whatever you feel comfortable with buying used, do so. Clothes, for example, are fine to buy used. Books, furniture, whatever you feel fine with. Locally sourced. You've probably heard this a lot before, but locally sourced foods and materials are really, really great for the environment. If you have to buy something, especially if you have to buy something new, like food, which you can't buy used, and if you could, ew. Locally sourced products are a lot better due to less transportation, which limits the amount of gases that are released into the atmosphere. So locally sourced is a lot better than things that are made far away that need to be like flown in or transported by boat or train. Just buy locally sourced things. And of course, something that might seem really small, but it really adds up. When you go shopping, bring your own bag. It's not that hard. You just take a fabric bag and you put it in your pocket and you bring it with you. It's really easy and, again, it limits your use of plastic. Spend your time as a vegan, or if you can't do that or don't feel like you want to, you can try cutting out animal products for like a limited time, however long you feel comfortable with. It doesn't have to be forever. You can just try it and see if you like it, and maybe you'll discover some new recipes to incorporate into your life more permanently. You never know. You can replace your meat with chicken or fish, which is also a lot healthier for you, because a lot of red meats are very bad for your heart and in general your cardiovascular system. It doesn't like those, so you can trade them for fish or chicken instead if you don't want to leave it out completely. You can drink water instead of milk with your meals, which is very easy to do because a lot of people don't drink milk with their meals to begin with. And also you can get the things that you get in milk by adding just a little bit of extra vegetables. And honestly, if you're eating healthy, you are probably already getting the stuff that you get from milk in the rest of your food. So you can just leave it out and drink water instead. Also, it takes 10 liters of water to produce 1 liter of milk. So there's a nice comparison for you. You can buy foods that are about to expire from your store, and most often they also come at a discount. So this is also great for your economy. Yay! You can give up flying for a year, or you can try not to fly at all. Or if you have to fly for your job, you can try to fly as little as possible, or you can try to replace those flights with some other kind of transportation, for example, trains. That's another thing. When you travel, try commuting. Trains and buses are a lot better than cars and planes. So if you're going somewhere as a group, instead of taking a car, you can take a bus or a train. If you like to travel and you want to keep traveling, but you still want to lower your carbon footprint a bit, instead of taking a lot of short vacations, you can go on one longer one, which limits the amount of time you spend flying, which limits your travel's impact on the environment. You can also try spending your holidays close to home. You can trade your regular car for an electric one if you have the money to do so. And if you live in an area where it's possible, You can just give up your car completely. For example, I don't have a car because I live in a city and I don't need one because my grocery store is literally so close I could throw a rock and hit it from my window. When at home, only do full loads of laundry or full loads of dishes if you have a dishwasher. If possible, do your dishes by hand because that uses a lot less water than using a dishwasher too. If you have control over the kind of heating that you use or the kind of electricity that you use, you can get geothermal heating, which is great for the environment and it pays for itself in just a few years. Or you can also get green electricity, which is something I unfortunately can't do because I don't have control of that because I rent and my electricity is kind of baked into the rent. So I can't do that. Sad. You can dry your clothing without a dryer. Just hang them. It's really not that hard. It takes a bit longer, yes, but it will save on your electricity bill and it will also save the environment. So don't use dryers. They are bad. It's also easier on your clothes because then they don't have to tumble around a second time. You can make your own garden if you have the opportunity to. Again, this is hard to do if you live in an apartment like I do. But what I do is I keep a lot of plants. And if you have a balcony, you can also have like a tiny like herb garden on it or just in general a lot of plants there. This is also something that helps you because plants produce oxygen, and in rooms where the oxygen level is high, people tend to feel happier and healthier and get less headaches. So this will also help you. Woo! You can take shorter showers because, let's be honest, you really don't need to shower for a full 15 minutes every single time. You just don't. You can spend less time in your sauna if you have one, because, you know, I'm Finnish, so like everyone has one. But if you're not Finnish, you probably don't. If you have a sauna, spend less time in it if you can. And don't take as many baths, which is something that I have recently started doing because I love taking baths. I love like nice breath bubbles and nice cider or maybe a glass of wine if I'm feeling really fancy and a good book. But I have actually cut down on my amount of baths to save some extra water. So that is also something that you can do. You can also put up a like no advertisements little tab on your mailbox. What are you doing? Estelle, she's climbing into a plastic bag. And finally, number 20, take good care of your fridge and freezer. This is something I know I should be better with, and I am going to try. Because taking care of your fridge and your freezer will lower the amount of electricity that they use to keep cold, which is, again, awesome. I hope you enjoyed the video. I just figured I would share a few tips that I have learned in my studies and in my personal life and some stuff that I also do myself, or at least things that I feel like I should be doing with you, and maybe you can find something that you are able to adapt into your own life. A lot of people can't give up certain products. If you like this video, give this a thumbs up so I know, and then maybe I'll make another one. Maybe there is a part two. Who knows? If you want to check out something else that I have made, you can click either there or there. And remember to subscribe to my channel because I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. And other than that, I will see you in the next one. Bye. Jesus, that is loud.